Hi. Today we want to discuss how to match a guitar amp impedance with the cab impedance. I bet you've been in the situation where you have had, say, a cab that has been 16 ohm, but the amp only puts out 4 ohm, or the reverse. How could that potentially damage the amp? And how would it influence sound and tone? And what can you do about it? Well, when it comes to tone, I have had 2 setups here. First, I play Marshall 2204 through an orange cabinet that is 4 ohm. And then I set the amp to all the different impedances. I'm matching and mismatch all the ways. So the amp has a higher impedance than the cab. Then I do it the other way around. I play it through Marshall cab. I use the Marshall 2204 with all impedances, 4, 8, 16. And the cab in that case is 16. So then the amp is smaller, lower impedance than the cab. So we're going to listen to all those combinations. Then we're going to check out a gadget called the C matcher from Weber. So that there you can basically set the impedance of the amp and the impedance of the cabinet, and then it compensates for any discrepancies. It's a really great product. I blew my mind when I found out it existed. Now I think everyone should have one of those. Because it kind of, regardless of what your amp and cab is, you can just hook them up together. Now, you shouldn't play you shouldn't play amp and cab with mismatches. It can potentially damage the amp. But a mismatch of 1 to 2, say 8 ohm to 16 ohm or vice versa, for a short while, that's not going to hurt the amp. But now you don't have to. You can get the Weber gadget and get away with it. Now, when it comes to how it influences the tone, of course, a match is going to give you more volume, better punch, and better clarity, string separation, and so on in the tone. But let's listen to it and discuss it in the comments. How does it influence the EQ, for instance, and so on? Or am I right that it has a big influence of dynamics and clarity and so on? All right, let's check it out. Cheers. We'll be right back.
Mm-hmm.